Good morning, and thank you for joining us for Coffee and Collaboration. Your host, Kimberly Winborn, will show you the power of proactive networking. Grab your coffee and let's get started.
Hi, y'all. We are here over at Tara Henry Studio, author and art on Rock Quarry Road, 3303 Rock Quarry Road in Raleigh. It's actually the side of town that I grew up in, not far from the church where my baby went to daycare and my brother worships Word of God Fellowship. So in an area that is very well known in Southeast Raleigh. And this is one of my favorite places to be. Tara Henry and I met about three years ago, mm-hmm. With Visionary Networking Circle, with which you all have heard me talk about. And so we were coming here, posting up, doing a lot of events. And I just wanted to come out, especially with the live podcast, and highlight authors and art and introduce Tara to those of you who don't know about her and don't know about the studio, because it's another opportunity to get an event space that will be able to fulfill the various needs that you may have, but also unique ideas that come from this brilliant woman. I mean, even down to the coffee cups here, which she's going to explain to you. This week we have our coffee cups thanks to Tara. I had bought some, but thanks to her, I wanted to use her signature items, and that's what this place represents for me. Uniquities, signature opportunities, signature events, and then home. Like when you walk in, like I was saying about Dion's place, it's just like home. Look at all the beautiful art behind us, and there's some more around us, and it's just like home. You definitely feel welcome here. So thank you for allowing us to come, Tara. So tell us about authors and art.
Oh, that's a loaded conversation, so hopefully we have time. I'll try to talk fast. How did it get condensed?
How did you get started here?
Well, it's fun because I actually did an in-home studio for a year before I went brick and mortar commercial location.
Yeah.
And then it just kept expanding because, like you said, home, I was literally in my home,
mm-hmm.
and I was inviting people in, and it was growing, and I wasn't supposed to be making it a business, but I couldn't stop thinking business-minded,
yeah.
since I was like a retail manager for like 20 years, and it was my job, basically,
yeah.
to come up with ideas, you know, to spark business. So I was inviting musicians in to entertain people and other small businesses, and I was like, you know what, you need to get out of your house.
I love it.
And see what happens with a more commercial space. So mm-hmm. that's what I did. Came here, and basically it really was... that was a blessing. This place is like really close to my home. So everything, the funny that you said home, because I really took things from my home. My husband's like, isn't that our, yeah, honey, yeah. But I wanted to still feel the same feeling when
yeah.
I was inviting people into my real house. I wanted that same warmth here.
Yeah.
And that's why I tell people, it's like, no, this is, people say, you know, business is business, it's not personal. This is really personal.
Yeah.
It began personal on a personal level, and I keep it on a personal level. Anybody walking through my door, it's already like, okay, mm-hmm. what are you, like, you came through my door for a reason.
Yeah.
It's my job to figure out what it is, but it's going to be a connection. There's going to be something that connects beyond. It's not just the art. People always want to talk about art with me.
Yeah.
It's funny. I don't know the latest artist. I did not study art. I don't want to talk for art philosophy, none of that. I want everybody to just relax and have fun
mm-hmm.
and get creative, which is really why, you know, when you the longer you do something, you get, it boils down to really the core and the heart. And it's no matter what I do, it all comes back to connection.
Yeah.
Connecting people to other people, connecting themselves to themselves, really.
Yeah.
Is really where this is going.
That's so important.
Creative wellness is like now like the banner that covers everything. Because no mm-hmm. matter what's happening, your wellness is involved. And it sparks from creativity.
Yeah. And that's so important. Like you said, connecting with yourself.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things as a business owner that I talk with people about is being authentic to mm-hmm. who you are. And there's so many layers to us. I mean, honestly, there's so many layers to us. But when we skip over a layer in communication with others, mm-hmm. that's such an opportunity missed to be able to connect, like you said,
yep.
to others. Because there could be a piece of your story that
exactly.
you're leaving out, but will impact somebody else. So I love that you said that, but we have to first connect with ourselves.
With yourself. Mm-hmm. And that's why I try to, because of course, you know I do things differently here. Yeah. Just point blank in store. I love it. The paint parties and just playing in paint, rah-rah. It really is about my people. Yeah. It's like each person. So I do things like the Tranquil Table, mm-hmm. where I have business people. I say business people particularly because they're the most stressed. Yeah. Because we, you know, especially the women. Mm-hmm. My men, they come in too, but the women, like you're the mother, you're the wife, you know, yeah. you're entrepreneur. We're wearing so many hats and we're always go, 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 and always looking fabulous and all that. This is that spot mm-hmm. where I want you not to be worried about how fabulous you look.
Right.
Because I'm more concerned about how fabulous you're feeling. Mm-hmm. And so I just want you to come sit down and listen. Most of the times we have the answer in ourselves. We yeah. just don't sit down.
Yeah.
And we don't listen Powerful. To it. So it's like, just sit down. I don't care if you're painting that day. It's going to happen organically. You're going to get still and you're going to get focused.
Yeah.
Tranquil Table, whatever it is. Now I do the crown services. Whatever I can get you to do to sit down for a minute and just like listen to your own voice. And even when I'm having business meetings with people, they come in with an agenda mm-hmm. and we're supposed to be talking about this thing. But in talking to them, if I don't see like spark in your eye about that thing, I'm like thinking, why are you doing this?
Yeah.
Like, so I like to talk to people to get to really what is it you want to do? Because mm-hmm. I'm going to, if I can, help you do that.
Yeah.
So you can do that other thing, like all the other 50 million connections you have. But what's that hidden passion that you have?
Yeah.
Like I'm finding out people who are just so straight collar business are really creatives.
Yeah.
And they've stopped painting. They've stopped sketching. They've stopped doing spoken word. They've stopped all of this. And I'm like, why did you stop?
Yeah.
Because that's going to help you with everything else.
Yeah.
So when you cut off that part, you cut off a major part of yourself.
That's so true. So it's like they're coming in here for a surface thing and you're actually getting to the deep.
Yes.
Which is crucial. I was thinking about, so for years I was on this personal development journey, right? Mm-hmm. And I did all of this immersion of like these personal development audios, going to all these leadership meetings and mm-hmm. different things like that. And that's what happened to me. Mm-hmm. Like I realized that my life was so like focused on that structure mm-hmm. that I lost some of the things that you just mentioned, like the poet in me, or I didn't even listen to music really anymore or watch TV and you know, and yeah, and those are the things that, now I don't recommend people watch TV all day, but there's some stuff that you can get inspiration.
That you really, really like.
Yeah.
Like, and I actually, it's funny because I miss all the new movies. I miss all the new shows. Mm-hmm. I'm missing all those boats. I will put on old stuff. Like yeah. stuff that reminds me of when I was growing up.
I love
so
that
even
too.
Like Matlock. Murder, She Wrote. I mean, Columbo. I'm watching old stuff.
Yeah.
Because for one thing, I noticed that I already know probably what's going to happen, mm-hmm. which actually, after a while, I tune it out, and I'm really listening to myself after a while, because I'm not trying to follow the story. I'm not trying to follow the characters.
Yeah.
It's on, and it's making me comfortable, but I'm still taking that time to really connect with something else. Mm-hmm. Even if I'm time traveling, I'm like, oh, simpler times, okay. And I'm like, well, what made them simpler times? And then I start getting reflective, and you know, all that. It's just naturally therapeutic.
Yeah.
I don't care if it's creativity, like you say, movies and shows, which is still creative.
Yeah.
That's still a lot of creativity yeah. in that. Storytelling. And I'm in here, I tell you, I listen to Mystery Radio all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Because I just need that little bit of creative energy happening, and then I still start connecting and getting ideas for myself.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, I love it. And, you know, speaking of all those ideas, I mean, we see a lot behind us and then looking around the room. Mm-hmm. What are some of those signature ideas that people can expect from you? So that maybe they haven't, you know, thought of. Mm-hmm. I keep saying signature because for me, that's who you are. You help people to be able to pull out
yeah.
things that are unique to them mm-hmm. and express it mm-hmm. through art or, you know, like you said, the creative wellness, whatever is their signature thing that mm-hmm. works for them. So what are some of the signature things that we can expect from you?
So signature also, I'm assuming, meaning different. So uh-huh. things that I do a little differently. So like I said, it's not your typical paint party. Because mm-hmm. I always begin each session with how many people have, you know, this is their first time.
Right.
And then I let everybody else know, this is your first time too, because I do it different, you know. Because my point is still, I want you to connect with yourself. I don't
yeah.
want you painting what I'm painting. I don't want you following my steps, because then we don't get to that inner artist that's in there that wants to just bust out.
Yeah.
Because we're so structured. You said structure earlier. Everything is structured. So when you sit down, I don't want to say, okay, now everybody take this brush and we're going to go in this blue paint and I want you to paint this like this. that is not fun for me. That cannot be fun for them. I mean, and it has its place. Because some people don't want to think. They're like, I just want to drone out and I just want to do this step by step. So that's what's different, is I want you to tap into something that you rarely have an opportunity to tap into.
Yeah.
Because we are so busy with expectations and all that. Nope, this is fun.
Yeah.
This is free for all. I don't, like, you cannot mess up. And I talk them through the process. So what they're going to get is me saying cue things and key things to help them get to that. Because most of the time, they're very, very nervous.
Mm-hmm.
They're thinking, oh my God, this is not going to look like yours. Great! Because it's not supposed to look like mine. It's supposed to look like yours.
Yeah.
And I have not had a person yet that by the end, they were like, you know what, you were right.
Yeah.
Even if they seemed like they were stressed the whole time, they figure out that thing.
Yeah.
And it's different for everyone. But I just still want to give you a space and a safe place to just explore that thing.
Yeah.
Without judgment.
I love that word, those words, safe space. So it's like you're creating, in when people walk in here, they should expect that safe space. And if they don't know it, they will find out in the process.
Yes.
And that's so powerful. That really is. I'm thinking about, like, looking at all of these. Are these things that you've drawn, or are these some of the... And so people can mimic or model these, or they can do their own creative...
I call this my gallery art, because as artists know, there's art that we do for ourselves.
Uh-huh.
We pour more into it. This is designed to be quick and simple so anybody can do it.
Yeah.
So I'll do a baseline sketch, but I leave a lot open for interpretation. Colors are always open for interpretation, whether it has a word on it or not. You add your own affirmations, because you discover, you know, and I always say, like, wait, even for the lipstick, like, wait for that lipstick. Wait to see what she's telling you, like, who she is. Like, don't just do what I do. Like, wait till she tells you who she is on that canvas.
Yeah.
But yeah, a lot comes by, call it designs by request, because even if I haven't made it yet, I'm capable.
Yeah.
So you don't have to, like, oh my God, I really wanted to do a peacock, but she doesn't have a peacock. There's no such thing.
Right.
I can sketch a peacock.
I
create original artwork that's themed. So I have a lot of the, you know, this is Delta. I have a lot of, you know, requests and organizations that come through, and they're like, hey, you know, can I want to do a heel because I have a walking in your faith thing I want to do. It's nothing but to ask.
Right.
And I'm like, going to get my little thinking cap on. So the gallery grows by what other people want to experience, because I like to tailor it. I'm not going to tell you what your art is for this.
Yeah.
What do you want to do?
I love it.
And the way I do it too, people can do different designs because it is so personal and you're not just watching me. We usually can have more than one design going, so it's more personal.
Yeah. And speaking of personal, I got a personalized signature painting for one of my events last year. Ryan Ray and I had an event, birthday brunch club, and it was called Taste of the Triangle. And so Tara was able to make me a picture, because I ended up taking it. Sorry, Ryan. But make me a picture. And when everybody came in for the event, they signed the picture. And so how do people get in touch with you to get that? And are you still doing that?
Yes, that is one of my most underserved services that I actually want people to take advantage of, because first of all, Raleigh is lit in surrounding areas.
Yeah.
There's events galore. There's no reason why people should not be requesting a signature event art piece.
I love mine.
But it's different, because when they walk in, they get to sign it, and sometimes they're surprised by it. Like, wait, we're supposed to write on the artwork? So it's already creating a new thought process, a new way of looking at things. Like, oh, because most art you can't touch.
Yeah.
You're in a museum, you're not supposed to touch the art.
Right.
I'm allowed to write on this, so it's already a heightened experience.
Yeah.
And I do personalize them for events. So, like, yours had your logo and Ryan's logo on it. Sorry, Ryan. But that's what makes it special. So you just tell me what the theme is, and I'll ask you, like, little questions, like, okay, so what's your favorite colors, or what's the color of the event?
Yeah.
And just, like, let me go. That's usually the best pieces, when you don't try to, like, micromanage me, because then it just ruins it.
Freedom.
Because if the passion's not in the piece, you can tell.
Yeah.
Like, oh, this was torture.
Yeah.
So if you just let me go, it's going to be great. But I think that is, and like weddings, it's like great for your guests to walk in and sign, and then the bride and the groom take a piece of artwork home. The applications are endless, so people apply me.
Yeah. I mean, when you say weddings, so engagement parties, because we
had
go
one
to,
yesterday.
Did you?
I did. Oh my goodness. He proposed to her in the morning.
Oh.
And then he arranged to come here for their special private couple session.
That is so nice.
And I did a signature art piece for them to memorize the day.
Yeah.
So it has the date on it, and it was fun. So definitely I'm do that too.
Yeah.
Hey, if you want to surprise somebody, you know, what you call it, elevate your status. You have a whole studio to yourself.
Yeah. Well, and then, like, so I know for a lot of events, we go to, they'll have a board for you to sign, mm-hmm. Like the engagement parties or birthday parties or things like that, especially the what do you call them, milestone years.
Yes.
And so to be able to have your own painting, it could be of you, it could be mm-hmm. of your family, you know, whatever it is, it could be you and your spouse, whatever it is that you guys work out that she creates. I just think about that, being able to have your guests sign to it. Sign that. But let me... backtrack just a second, because as you were talking about the signature events for events, mm-hmm. then I was thinking about bridging communities or building communities, because you know that's big for me. Networking is about being able to have intentionality in your connections and relationships mm-hmm. to build those collaborations, which is the reason for the show, right? Mm-hmm. So if I'm coming to an event, I don't know anybody here. I get there, there's a signature piece about the event that I get to now connect just by writing my name beside someone else. You guys don't know the power of connection, especially the power of writing. Yep. And so you sign your name on that piece that brings that community together instantly almost. And if you don't believe me, it can't hurt to try it, right? If it's going to build your business, it can't hurt to try it. But I'll tell you, it worked for us for that event. It did.
It really does. And because people, especially like you said, you don't know anyone.
Yeah.
And it's a conversation starter if it's nothing else. It's like, oh my God, did you see that piece? Did you get to sign it? And then people start talking.
Yeah.
And speaking of bridging gaps and networking and community building, one thing that I always tell people too, especially if you do events here, because you know I host other things than paint parties, we do venue rentals, book signings, all that kind of thing, is I like people to be prepared to talk about themselves.
Yeah.
You know, because even when we're showing up to support somebody else, we're always still in the room, and you miss opportunities when you don't talk to people.
That's true.
I think every opportunity should be an opportunity to get to know who's in the room.
Yeah.
Because they're there for a reason. So far, I have not had one event, even if it was a low turnout.
Yeah.
Like the four people in that room needed to be the four people in
that room.
And they needed the opportunity to focus on each other, because great things have happened every time.
Yeah.
So that's also why I don't cancel events. If mm-hmm. the count's low, like we're still doing this thing. I'm committed to being there for whoever dedicated their time to show up.
Yeah, I love
so
that.
So we turn it into the most powerful experiences.
Yeah.
And, you know, we take pictures and promote all day. We have
fun. I believe in that, that intimacy. It really does, you know, help to bridge
and
those
relationships. And that's the intimate spot. That's what's different. This is private.
Yeah.
So I actually let people do workshop retreats. I've had two here so far where it's all day meetings. And
okay.
they really got to boil down to the core of even, because they're here to build mm-hmm. team building and resolve mm-hmm. some things. You can't have certain conversations in a coffee shop. You can't have certain conversations, you know, in the middle of a restaurant, because there's still other people around.
Yeah.
Here, and you know, I got the feedback. It's like, you know, you really helped us become a stronger team, because we were able
nice.
To have the meeting and the conversation we needed to have.
Yeah.
With the language that was appropriate and whatever needed to be expressed. Some things you can't say.
Right.
But it's private in here. You know, I got disclosure. I'm not saying nothing. Yeah. Whatever you're doing is what you're doing.
Yeah.
And then they followed that up with a paint session at the end. So you got to complete what needed to happen business-wise, but then you got to have fun together.
I love that.
And that whole process that just, you mm-hmm. know, it was a beautiful thing. So I want to have more of those.
Yeah, workshops, venue, rental, anything you could possibly think of where you need a venue. What is the size max for if someone's looking?
So if it's a seated paint party type situation, I like to say 24 because I like to have people have room.
Mm-hmm.
But I can do 30 for a paint party. If it's non-tables, you just need chairs. So like a book signing where you need more audience structure or it's a poetry thing, I can do up to 50 for that.
Awesome.
Seated. Yeah, I have seated availability for that. And this baby transforms. Mm-hmm. I mean, you walk in here one day, you're like, okay, paint party, next look, oh my goodness. Like, you know, we've actually had the table, not tables, the chairs in a circle. It was such a community powerful impact conversation that we were having that day for that workshop. And the feeling was like, oh my God. Like, people weren't even in the chairs yet. And I was like, I was like, oh my goodness, the feeling. The energy was ridiculous. So I keep telling people, bring me your ideas.
Mm-hmm.
If they work, they work. I mean, if they don't, they don't. If it's, you know, space is too small or it's not the right kind of vibe, because I'm very serious about my vibe.
Vibes are important.
My energy is very important to me. So
yeah.
if it's something that I'm not peaceful with, I'm not going to be able to show up and give you the best of what you need because I'm going to be stressed out. And I don't do stress.
We can't do stress. Not in creative wellness.
No. You know, that part is not meant to be personal, but if it happens, then I think it's a good opportunity to develop and grow.
Yeah.
Because whatever that thing is needed some working on, or it was a disconnect or whatever.
Yeah.
But it's good for just building and fortifying your relationships with people because I like genuine relationships.
I do too.
If it's not working, then we got to reflect. Why didn't that work? Something wasn't right. Yeah. And we can always come back and revisit, mm-hmm. have discussion and conversation, because I never want anybody to think anything is ever done maliciously or she didn't like my business or I wasn't all that to her. No, it's just it wasn't right or something wasn't aligned right or, you know, something needed to be developed.
Mm-hmm.
Because people, we all have call ourselves businesses. Brick and mortar is a little different.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we're talking there's insurance, there's overhead, rules, there's things.
Mm-hmm.
And so I can't just haul off and do whatever we're talking about. It's like, okay, is that insurance covered? Is that is that the right numbers?
More to think about.
You know, I have to think about these things. So I never want anybody to think that it was them or mm-hmm. it was their idea, was whatever. It just probably didn't align with brick and mortar business rules, because there is more structure.
Right. And I mean, with that being said, how can tell everybody how to get in contact with you to book or to have a paint party or whatever they need?
So social media, of course, you know, it's huge. So Authors and Art is all over social media. Tara Henry, my page is also very open to people because that's that relationship part. I mean, there's nothing really I'm posting that should mm-hmm. be damaging. So look for Tara Henry. You can't miss me. Art's all over it. Authors and Art. .com is my website. AuthorsandArt.com /contact is what I'm trying to teach people to use because it's very simple. So it's contact.
Right.
So you leave me messages because a lot of times, this is a one-woman show. So I don't have a team. I don't have a staff. I don't have no other artists. So you're reaching me. And sometimes I'm in the middle of an event or, you know, I do have my own mother-wife duties. But I want to get back with you. So by all means, leave me messages. Some people tell me they call, they don't leave a message. I'm like, why are you not leaving a message? Like, I don't know what you want.
Right.
So leave me a message. We can handle a lot through just texting and that kind of email situation. We don't always have to be on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
AuthorsandArt.com/contact. I'm trying to also train people because they keep missing the public events.
Because mm-hmm.
social media, you know, algorithms, whatever. AuthorsandArt.com/reservations usually has all the public events. And if you just routinely check, you won't miss as much.
So AuthorsandArt.com/reservations for all events. And AuthorsandArt.com/contact to message and get in contact with Tara to be able to book here. You got to come. You got to come. You got to come. So I just want to say thank you once again for allowing us to stop by Coffee and Collaborations to check out your space and tell everybody else about how much we love it. You guys make sure to check us out at www.coffeeandcollaborations.com, and you can get connected to all of these amazing community leaders, other entrepreneurs, get some tips and some information as to how you can network well, collaborate, mm-hmm. learn how to do that well, and just stay in touch. We want to also get feedback as to what you're thinking about the show. I was telling you guys a couple weeks ago on the audio version that California is loving us, so come on, North Carolina. Pick it on up.
If I lived in Italy, I would be the bomb.
But we love you too, North Carolina, especially Raleigh. You know, that's my city. So thanks again, Tara, so much. Thank you so much. This is one of my favorite spaces, like I said. And so if you're looking for creative wellness of all ages, mm-hmm. come and check out Authors and Art. You have the information. And make sure to be a light. I always say that. Be kind. Be loving. Think about your hello as you enter the grocery store, as you mm-hmm. pump gas at the gas station, whatever it is you're doing. Think about your hello, because what you give is what you're going to get. Have a great rest of the week. See you next time on Coffee and Collaborations.